I left out of Tucson with no destination in mind. I was running from trouble and the jail term the judge had in mind.
Shouldn't get too drunk there.
Drink number one of 2000 or Norm Bill Deer Hunt. That's why I thought I'd get to go. Alright, first of all, I'd like to say that if you're ever trying to save money on a flight and you put in a layover, you need to factor in your bar bill.
My first night in Juarez, I lost all the money I had.
Please fall.
One bad señorita made use of one innocent lad. But I must keep on running, it's too late to turn back. I'm wanted in Tucson, I know. Yeah, and things will blow over on the seashores of old Mexico. Two Mexican farmers en route to a town I can't say. Let me ride on the back of a flatbed half loaded with hay. Down through Durango, Colima, Palmira, then into Manzanillo, where I slept in the sunshine on the seashores of old Mexico. After one long siesta, I came wide awake in the night. I was startled by someone who shadowed the pale moonlight. My newfound companion, one young señorita, who offered a broken hello. The gringo she found on the seashores of old Mexico. She spoke of Sonora and swore that she'd never return. Her Mexican husband, she really had no great concern. But she loved the gringo, my red hair. That's all I needed to know. Yeah, I found what I needed.
Hey, Mitch. How do the Democrats do it?
They do it just like you, buddy.
Send the head of the table. Doubt it.
That's all I needed to know.
He's a bucket. He's a nice buck.
Yeah, I found what I needed on the shores of old Mexico.
Mitch. Didn't get to look at him, but from fucking him running away, he looks like a fucking dandy, bud.
I've seen him do.
Mitch, get ready to fucking lay hammer. Take your time, squeeze the trigger. I can't tell if he was like 33.
All the first.
What's your 4-day buck prediction?
All right, predictions for bucks. I don't have any predictions on who's gonna shoot first because I feel like there's gonna monster gonna come out of the gate.
Marcus's hunt started out like all the other ones. We on the way there, we had a brief conversation regarding what he was looking for, what kind of traits he wanted, and what I had seen on the ranch the previous weeks. After that, we weaseled over to what we now named Marcus's Mountain. I had seen some bucks over there the previous weeks there on the shady side. And it was an awful cold morning, and so we decided, let's start on the east side where the sun was hitting first thing. It wasn't long before we saw a doe. She was actually bedded down in the sun just on the side of the hill. Pulled up, stopped, raised up the high lift, and looked around, tried to get different angles, see if there's anything else with her. Made some fawn in distress sounds, and then ended up actually getting multiple does up, and then caught a glimpse of a, looked like a large frame buck. After a few seconds trying to decipher him where he was in the brush, he ended up sneaking out the backside and going up the side of the hill, which allowed us a really good look at him. He was a 3x3, very heavy and wide. Once I saw him go up the top of the hill, I could judge his width, and Mike, Marcus's father, said, "Hey, that looks like about a 30-inch buck." And I'm like, "That thing is a solid 34-inch buck." And at that point, width being one of the characteristics that Marcus really wanted, we knew we wanted to spend some time looking for this buck. We finished the rest of the day looking for that particular buck to no avail. Saw a few other deer, but nothing that we were had our mindset that this buck here was our number one target. The next morning, we believed that the buck would stay in the general area, so we went right back over to Marcus's mountain and started glassing over there. On the way over to the east side, coming around on the south side, we saw a few bucks and deer on the side of the hill, which turned out to be about 7 bucks fighting, chasing over obviously a hot doe.
Big fucking 34-inch three-pointer.
So we drove up there right over the north, and it wasn't more than 100 yards on the north side when we picked up the buck.
I liked it when Rob says, "Kill that buck."
The 3x3, Mike had saw him bedded right underneath a tree, just in the shade, wide out in the open, there, as still as can be. A quick look verified him. And I told Marcus to let him have it.
What the fuck, Marcus? Tell me what's going on there, brother. Huh?
Yeah, yeah.
There's his lady.
Yep. Hey, buddy. What do you think about that shit?
Fucking awesome. It's huge.
Look at pin holding, man. Beautiful shot.
Oh, that yeah. First one I hit broke his leg too. I think it was somewhere right here.
Hey. Thank you. He's blonde.
Jeez.
He's blonde. Right there. Like that.
Huh?
Fuck, buddy.
Oh, you spotted it. Oh,
fuck yeah. Look at that fucking thing. Huh? I know. You don't get much fucking better than that son of a bitch. He
man.
Is. He's 30.
He's fucking
there. He's fucking out there, isn't he?
And the rest is history. He made a great shot on him, and we ended up having a heavy 3x3, 34 inches wide Sonoran mule deer.
My first rifle was a 243. The papa gave daddy and daddy gave to me. And they taught me how to shoot with a steady hand. Guess there's some you don't understand. Now I grew up on a prison farm, sneaking push out from a mason jar. Used to go fishing out Pickle Creek Dam. But I guess there's some you don't understand. Grandma.
Yeah, boy. 34 inch, huh?
Put him out there a little bit, and he's huge, but you don't have to.
Damn,
holy
boy.
Fuck. So he's paying attention here. all these does come in, whatever, there's a couple other bucks or whatnot, and I'm like, yeah, all right, cool. Well, they fuck off, and after a minute, I keep blowing, whatever. I'm like, hey, over here, you got another buck coming.
That's how it is. But it's not this animated.
And he's like, whatever. I'm like, it's 3x4, but... It's
not this animated.
No. Comes through, big time.
I'm like, that's a pretty big deer. He comes through another thing, and it turns and looks at us. I'm like, hey, he's like... 34, he's only
3x4,
he's like 34.
There was only a
3x4. I said he's a 3x4, but he's 34 and probably 185 plus, like possibly 190, like I don't know. So this fucker runs around. He's on the ranch, we can't even hunt to begin with, okay? He's over here fucking off where we can't kill him. Well then guess what? He goes ahead and jumps fence, comes over on our side where he's free game. We pull up, stop, and the buck's like 60 yards, 80 yards, 100 yards, 110 yards. It's like, shoot me!
Had to tell him though. Like you have to say shoot
me. Hey.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go. And guess what? You guys caught it.
How lucky was it that you guys caught it? Oh my god, dude, it was stupid.
2% chance, not even.
Yeah, if that. We hit this corner, and I turned and headed down the road, and he goes, you're hoping for a party down the corner, ain't you? And I said, I'm hoping so.
So I told my Pat, because the first day, our first day driving down there.
There he is.
The first day driving down there, he said, I just had a party down here. I said, oh yeah? And he goes, yeah, we killed 197. He goes, 197 inch buck down the week before we came down, right?
3-pointer, too. Like
the week before we came down.
Yeah.
He goes, we had a party down here. So we're almost down there because I already know this part of the ranch.
Yeah.
I go, you ready for a party? And he's like, I hope so. And I take my can of Zins, I put one in, I take one out. I throw it off the high rack for the deer gods. I did. I'm not kidding. I fucking put it in my pocket. I'm like, hopefully this is it. We go down. We make the right-hand turn. And as soon as we make the turn, he goes. And I'm like,
I was pointing. Because I saw the doe for a ways off.
Yeah.
She's obviously rich. But, you know, so I'm like, I looked back at him.
I wasn't
going to
tell anybody.
Like this, like. There's trees on the backside of the trees, so he's like, all right.
We're
driving past the trees, driving past the trees, driving past the trees, driving past the trees. And yeah. I set the hook on the driver, right? on poor Brewer. And about that time, a doe takes off, and I'm like, fuck, it's just a doe. And a buck runs out with a doe. The doe stops right in front of him. I'm like, fuck. And I'm like...
This is the second time.
Yeah, this is when he killed him. This is when he killed him. So a doe runs off, a doe and a buck walks out, and they swap. One doe's pointing that way, and the buck's pointing that way. And I'm like, fuck. And I look back at him to say something. Well, he's already got off safety. I'm like, oh, fuck, all right. So I'm pretty certain what buck it is. And this is all happening like...
This is within a...
0.7 seconds. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like this. Well, that little doe takes one step, and I'm like, that's 3x4. Boom! And I was like, yeah, he's a little bit out there.
Hey, Luke Lavinich came on in hot, nails it. Prediction spot on. Love it.
Yeah, I'll let you know.
Big buck!
Smile for the camera, but we'll tell them how big it's going to be today. Oh, well.
Hey.
Mucho grande.
Look at that.
Muy
grande, yeah.
Muy.
Hey, Rafa. Go, yeah, fucking six of them. 12 of them. Fuck. Pull ice.
Let's see, wait. We had a group of guys that come from a place we don't usually like hunters, or we don't like people coming from there, but these guys were exceptions and we're good with that. They lost their bags and the only way they could keep warm, it seemed, was to buy a case of beer each and drink that. So by the time we saw them, they arrived at camp, they were lit up, asking us where we keep the deer tied up for them. Where are the big bucks tied up? Well, heck, guys, that's fifth day secrets. We can't be telling them that on first evening. But they managed to get them tucked in and to bed that night. We got hunting in the morning. It was cold. They had no clothes, but thankfully Bo had a down jacket. That down jacket saved them for sure. I was starting to get cold in my burner parker and my mittens. We didn't see any deer, and for about 3 days, I think we saw one buck that was had something on his head, 1 3-year-old maybe. So after 3 days of that, Bo packed the sad and traded me in for another guide. Rob stepped up to the plate and got her done. I got crook. It was a disaster there at the end. Anyway, I bailed out and went south and they brought her home. So all in all, good deal. Good way to end the season.
I've learned that hola is hello in Spanish. Gracias is thank you. Mucho grande bucko is shoot the motherfucker.
Hey, guess what we get to do today?
Fucked up.
Are we doing the... Yeah.
Drank a little grain alcohol or hauled a little hay. But if you think your boots got more dirt than mine, I got one thing to say. My town's smaller than your town, and I got a bigger bucking bass on my wall. I got a little more kick in my draw, y'all. I got a little more spit in my jaw. And my truck's louder than your truck. You might think that you're redneck, but I'm rednecker than you. Yes, I am. I got a car parked in my front yard with a floorboard full of Slim Jims. I piss where I want to, and I fish where I swim. Yeah, I bet you ain't got it on a tailgate or killed a copperhead.
Buddy.
Tell us about Sonora, Mexico. What have you learned today?
Well, boys, sounds like we're heading out to Sonora in the perfect time of year. Rut's on, third week into the rut. It's the coolest week since the rut's happened, so sounds like we're on the buck should be rut during the day, not tonight. Lunar phases, all going.
The lunar phases line up the feeders enough for you to see.
Marty boy.
Here we go, first morning getting in this high rack. How you feeling, man?
Let's go, baby. Make it happen. Well, Brandon up here. Let's go, Brandon.
Here we go.
that thing right there. Go get it, Mitch. Holy shit, how big is that thing?
Fucking hammer. Inchy gringos.
Damn. Whoa.
On the last night of the hunt, we were rolling down the fence line where we'd seen all the deer, the most deer we'd seen all hunt. And I just get a text from Rob saying they're, him and the boys are headed up on the hill to spot for us for the last hour of light.
How big is that thing?
And we're headed down the down by the cave hill, and sure enough, we get a flat tire at 5 o'clock crunch time, hour of light left. So we bail off, change a flat tire really quick. We hadn't hardly seen a deer all day. Jump back in the high rack after we get the flat tire fixed. We got about 45 minutes of light. Go down past the cave hill where Rob and the rest of the guys are glassing for us. They hadn't seen much. We go through the fence where the orange pile is. Seen a couple does. Now we probably got about a half hour of light left. Morale's getting pretty low. We're trying to decide what to do for the last 45 minutes, and Rob calls us on the radio and says he's got a no-doubter on the run chasing some does. So we whip and spur Sikio in the high rack as fast as we can down the road. We go north down the road as fast as we can. It's getting super, super dark. And we find a little shortcut where Rob tells us the deer is. And we cross country it off the road. We're going right where Rob's telling us. We flash the headlights on the truck to give the guys an idea where we're at on the hill. They see us, they radio us into this little brush patch where they'd last seen the buck. We're up, we go down the left-hand side of it. It's getting super dark at this point. Can't find the deer, I'm calling, can't find the deer. So now we go back out the road and go around, and we go right through the brush where Rob and the guys had last seen the buck. Sure enough, he pops out, chasing the doe. It's low light. The buck chases the doe out. We're trying to get a shot at him. We're like at 100 yards, can't get a shot. Finally, he turns around, chases a doe back, and Mitch lights him up. And made one heck of a trip.
Get your ass over here, boy.
Holy fucking God, baby. Holy fucking, let's go, baby.
Ah. Yeah, oh, boy.
That's a 3x3. Fuck, we shot him all day.
Fuck yeah, that's cool.
Nice. Fuck yeah. Holy fuck.
Oh. Walk off.
Hey, come on, hop off.
Go for it.
Wait.
Hold on, hold on.
Three.
Go. Dude, you got smoked. Mitch won.
Oh, come on. Of course you did. Shut up.
Emptiness in my heart. Too old to be wild and free still. Too young to be over the hills. Trying to grow up, but who knows where to start. So I just sit right here and have another beer in Mexico. Do my best, waste another day. Let the warm air melt these blues away. I sun sinks down and I've seen them both in this tourist town. Up for days in a rage, just trying to search my soul for all the answers and the reasons why I'm at this crossroads in my life, and I really don't know which way to go. So I'll just sit right here and have another beer in Mexico. Do my best to waste another day. Sit right here and have another beer in Mexico. Let the warm air melt these blues away. Maybe I'll settle down, get married, or stay single and stay free. Which road?
Yeah.
Do my best, waste another day.
Vamanos.
Vamanos to the